Okay. So like everyone others, I would like to thank the organizers for this nice conference and giving me an opportunity to give a talk here. And also I would like to thank the audience here for coming. Now it is not very trivial, I think. So this time I would like to speak about the problem of periodic orbit counting. So we consider some flow on a manifold, Ft, M to M. And we assume that, so this is a flow, and this is non-singular. Okay. And we count the number of periodic points whose period is less than given number some t. So we count the number of periodic orbit, and here gamma is prime periodic, so periodic orbit, and we denote by this the period of gamma. Okay, so, and we want to see what is the asymptotic of this number. So, for example, if you take the timeline, and maybe after some times you find one periodic orbit here, and then if the flow is hyperbolic, say Anosov, then you will find more and more periodic orbit, right? And we want to see how the number increase. Okay. And there are several works on it. And maybe one of the beginning observation is that in some flows of some hyperbolicity, then maybe this is maybe proportional to, or if you take a log and divide by t, then it's like, I'm confusing. So maybe this is what is well known. So basically this grows exponentially first, and this rate is topological entropy. Okay, but if you restrict ourselves to some more specific system, then we can get a better estimate. Okay? And one well-known theorem is something called prime periodic orbit theorem. This is first observed by Margulis for geodesic flow on negatively curved manifold, and then proved in much more general setting by Parry and Porigot. So for example, if we assume that the flow is Anosov flow, and assume that it is mixing, or topological mixing, or actually the theorem by Parry and Porigot treats a more general setting, but here we restrict ourselves to this setting. Then the number of periodic orbit is given in this formula. So there's some small error term, O1, but basically, pi t is given by this one. So basically, okay, the ratio of the left-hand side and that integral is become close to 1. So it gives a very precise asymptotic for the number of periodic orbit. Okay, and here H is a topological entropy. And it is a very well-known theorem, and it's a kind of analogy of prime number theorem in dynamical system setting. Okay, and more recently, if we restrict ourselves further, so to the contact Anosov flow. What is contact Anosov flow? So if the manifold N carries one contact form, and we assume that the answer flow preserves that contact form. And this, if you don't know this, maybe you can imagine that this is a geodesic flow on a negatively curved manifold. Okay, then in that case, actually this error term is actually exponentially small with respect to t. So we can get, this term can be written like this. It is proved by Poincaré and Chubb in two-dimensional setting, and three-dimensional, I think. And then in higher dimension, proved by Stroyanov more recently. Okay, so this is quite sharp result for number of periodic orbit. It's already very satisfactory, I think. But I want to go further. And if you consider the case of a geodesic flow for hyperbolic surface, then we can use some formula called Selberg trace formula and give this very precise formula. So this is much more precise now, formula for the number of periodic orbit. So here, so the main term is the same, but now we have a few resonance term, and then we have some error term. And the error term here is e to the rho t, and rho is 3/4 of entropy. So actually this is big, so exponentially big, but compared to this, it is much smaller, right? And this resonance term have some intermediate growth. Okay, let me add that. So in this case, because the curvature is constantly 1, so actually entropy is 1. And the these numbers, so that appears in the resonance term, is related to the eigenvalues of the Laplacian in this way. So these are real numbers. Okay, and my question is that how general does this kind of asymptotic formula hold to? So I want to show this kind of formula up to some resonance term for more general Anosov flow or a contact Anosov flow. So let me, so now throughout this talk, I want to mention this formula. So this is sometimes called Fulbert's formula. So this is the main term, t to the e h t dt plus some resonance term. Okay. T to the e chi I t dt plus some error term. Okay. And actually, I have one result in this direction. So, actually, I have this formula, but for contact, general contact and so forth. For example, I have one formula which holds for geodesic flow on negative curve on the negatively curved surface, so especially in variable curvature case. And in this case, the error term is of this form. So this form. So we actually take. I had to write t here. Sorry. So the error term is like O. Exponential, and okay, we take average of h and half of maximal Lyapunov exponent. Sorry. Okay. So this is what I actually what I can prove. And okay, but okay, one remark is that now the this resonance term may be complex. But anyway, so we have this. So this is rho. So we have asymptotic estimate like this. And I like this result very much because if we consider the constant curvature case, then maybe so this maximum Lyapunov exponent coincides with topological entropy. So this error term or this rho becomes 1/4 of 3/4 of entropy. So this is just the same as the case of Huber. So it is very nice. But actually, if this ratio or this, so usually the maximum Lyapunov exponent is bigger than topological entropy. So this is bigger than 1. So then this estimate is very good if this ratio is close to 1. But if it becomes greater than 2, then if you look at this, then the second term, so lambda max over 2, becomes h, or bigger than h. Then this error term is bigger than the main term. So this is quite vacuous. And so in some cases, it gives a very good estimate for error term, but sometimes it's very bad. And maybe in the purpose, one purpose of this talk is how this happens. And maybe I want to give one remedy in a rather simplified setting. Okay. Now, so this is a motivation. Okay. Now, I want to consider the problem. So actually, I'm speaking about rather technical problem. But I want to emphasize that this kind of problem is somewhat universal in the field of quantum chaos or wave chaos. And it has some very similarity because you see that, okay, here we have some condition that the maximum Lyapunov exponent is bigger than twice of entropy. And this kind of condition sometimes happens in this area. And in one side, everything goes well. And the other side, we don't know anything. And maybe we can think of this problem as a counterpart of that kind of problem in dynamical system. So I want to explain the problem and then give some solution for it. Okay, and since I want to extract the essence of the problem, I want to consider things in a very simplified setting. So we don't consider the anisoflows, but we consider some very simple expanding semiflow. This is a suspension flow of an angle multiplying map on the circle. So we consider mapping tau, which is just an angle multiplying map on the circle. So maybe if you like, you can just consider angle doubling. And then we consider some loop function. Okay, and it should be smooth. And then we can consider this suspension semiflow of that kind of mapping. So maybe this kind of mapping flow has appeared in this conference twice or three times. So the flow is like this. So the phase space is this one. So S1 cross R, but in this R direction, we put this restriction. So the orbit goes up by constant speed. And if it reaches to the upper bound, it goes down. But when it goes down, we apply the mapping tau. Okay. So basically, it is an expanding flow, but actually, this is not one-to-one, so expanding semiflow. And we consider things in this simplified setting. Okay, then everything becomes much rather simple. And to consider this kind of problem on periodic orbit counting, actually, one secret is to consider transfer operator and its spectral picture, to get a spectral picture of it. So this time, so the related transfer operator is this. So this is an transfer operator acting on the function on the phase space. And this is simply defined by this formula. So this just push forward functions by the semiflow. And if, but of course this is, this map, this flow is, this is semiflow. So actually several point comes to one point by, and if the time is T is large, then this for each point Z, the point satisfying this condition is very large. Number of such points is very large. But anyway, so we define the transfer operator like this. So locally, it's a very simple transfer operator. There's no coefficient. And the relation to this transfer operator and periodic orbit counting is given by the so-called Atiyah-Bott trace formula. Okay. So we consider the trace of this transfer operator. But usually LT is not a trace class operator. So here we write down LT as an integral operator like this. KT x y ui, and this integral kernel is rather singular, so KT x y is delta ft minus 1 x minus y. So this is a Schwarz kernel of this transfer operator. And the flat trace is actually defined. So this is the definition. Is the integral of this Schwarz kernel along the diagonal. So this is not a usual trace, but anyway, this is a kind of trace of for operator LT, and we can compute it. And if you compute it, then you will get this formula. So first, maybe you can just easily observe that this integration is related to the periodic point, but because this takes non-zero value only around the periodic orbit, right? And if you do some a bit more careful computation, you will get this formula. Okay. And then there's one remark. So here d gamma is the expansion rate along the periodic orbit. So if you go along the, so this is a periodic orbit, then you, if you consider Poincaré map at some point, then you consider the derivative of the prime Poincaré map at this point. And then you will get d gamma. Okay. So we take this sum. So this is actually this, not a usual function of t in usual sense. This is a distribution. So at some point, so when t is a multiple of period of some prime periodic orbit, a prime period, then it takes, we put some Dirac image on it. Okay. And we take sum over all the periodic prime periodic orbit and take sum with respect to n, natural number n. Okay. And maybe it is easy to observe that this effect of this factor and also sum over n bigger than 2 is relatively small. And if you do some estimate, then we can show that we can drop this up to some small error term. And you will get this formula. So number of prime periodic orbit is given by this integration up to error term of this size. And this is actually much smaller than that we will have as an error term. So basically we can ignore this. So we can express the number of periodic orbit with this by using this integral. Okay. Ah, yes, in this case, yes. But note that this is not a trace in the usual sense. Okay. But now I ask you to admit that actually this is related in some sense to the spectrum of LT. So for example, if LT is a finite dimensional matrix, and one parameter family, then I think you can easily imagine that you will find have this kind of formula for the number of periodic of this integral, right? So if it is finite dimensional, and if you take this as a trace, then maybe this chi I should be, chi I and h should be the spectrum of the generator of LT. Okay, so if the things are finite dimensional, everything goes well and we don't have an error term. Now we extend this idea to this setting. So for this, we introduce a notion of essential spectral radius. So if we are given a bounded operator L, and we and suppose that it is an compact perturbation of L0, and L0 has a operator norm smaller than or equal to L lambda, then we know that the spectrum of L on the outside of the disk of radius lambda consists of discrete eigenvalues. Okay? And the infimum of such lambda is called essential spectral radius of L. Okay? So we try to consider arbitrary compact operator and we consider this decomposition. And we see that how small we can make the operator norm L0 small is. Okay. And so basically we can reduce the problem of periodic orbit counting to the spectral problem on the LT, and especially reduced to this question of estimate of essential spectral radius choosing some appropriate space function space. if the we know that essential spectral radius is small, then maybe we get this spectral picture. And then we get this asymptotic formula for the periodic orbit. And basically, the eigenvalues outside this essential spectral radius appear as this resonance term. So maybe it should be true that the largest eigenvalue should be h, or e to the ht for LT. And essential spectral radius should be related to this number rho. And to tell the truth, actually by some technical reason, this number, rho, does not coincide with the essential spectral radius. Actually, we have to take the average with entropy. This is a rather technical problem, so I want to avoid this. But anyway, the truth is that by technical reason, we have to take average. So for example, in the case of constant geodesic flow on the hyperbolic surface, actually, essential spectral radius should be e to the half of entropy times t. And the Huber theorem gives here we have a three-fourths of h. And so and at this moment, we cannot avoid this technicality. Anyway, if we get very good estimate on the essential spectral radius of the transfer operator, then we get a good estimate on the, this error term. This is true. Okay, now I want to go into more detail of the structure of the transfer operator. So we are considering some semiflow, and as we saw, the flow is locally just a translation, go up. So it is very natural to consider the frequency decomposition of the function with respect to the frequency in the flow direction, because this is the frequency should be preserved, right? And because there's some recurrence, so and the manifold itself is compact, so we cannot do this decomposition completely, but mentally it's possible. So suppose that it's possible, so we decompose the function on the space XF with respect to the frequency in the flow direction. Okay. It is virtually true. Of course, in detail, we have to do something, but for this moment, let us consider that this is true. So then the LT preserves that decomposition. It implies that LT is basically decomposed into countably many operators, okay? And each of operator is just the action of LT on the function space, on the space of function who have fixed frequency in the flow direction. Okay, so things like this. So if you consider this operator, L omega T, and omega denotes the frequency. Okay, so we consider some functions. Okay, we just look at a local picture of the flow. So in some neighborhood point, there is some function, and maybe I'm writing this black line, the point which has the same phase, complex phase. Okay. And then, since our mapping or our semiflow is expanding in the direction transversal to the flow, so after a long time, actually this circle, so this neighborhood is expanded in the horizontal or the direction that is transversal to the flow. So we will get this kind of picture at least in the universal coupling. And then finally some point comes to one point, because okay, this is a picture on the universal coupling, but now we finally have to go down to the manifold XF. Okay, so the operator is somewhat simple. So locally, it looks like this. Okay, so we consider some function of this form. So we have it have a fixed frequency in the forward direction, and we expand it, and then we cut off some part, and superpose it. This is the operator we are considering. So essentially, the problem is the following. So suppose that we have some function like this. So this is a wave function, simple plane wave function in the direction ck. And I suppose that there is complex phase, but absolute value is just a, or just one, say, sometimes. Okay, and we superpose those functions, okay? So we will get some functions, and maybe there is some interference between them. And we ask, what can we say about the result? Of course, it depends on the choice of these numbers. For example, it's for choice of these directions. And maybe one question is that, can the result of superposition can concentrate on very small subset? This is a question. Maybe let me explain, go back again by this setting. Okay, so here, okay, let us try to estimate the operator norm of LT omega. So first we consider L infinity norm. Okay, then from this process, so okay, this is just for just expansion, and okay, so if you look things in L infinity norm, there's nothing, just the norm is preserved. Okay, and then we consider superposition. Actually, this number is proportional to e to the ht, right? E to the ht. This is a number of backward orbit here, coming to here. So if you consider the L infinity estimate, then actually we get this estimate. But this is trivial. Basically, this gives the main term on the, give nothing else. Okay. Because this is not a good estimate, because it does not consider any cancellation between the functions. Because this, there are many complex phase. So if you add, there should be many cancellations between the functions. Okay, and to look at those cancellation, actually L2 norm is the best one. So actually we call the L2 norm, and we suppose some transversality condition. So we suppose that these frequency directions are transversal to each other. Okay. Then, okay, in this process, actually we have this estimate, this growth of L2 norm, because the area is expanding by this very, this weight, chi, okay, sorry, this should be lambda max, but yeah, lambda max t. So since we consider L2 norm, maybe we have to divide by 2. Then we superpose it, but then actually, if the frequency directions are different, then they are orthogonal in L2 norm. So basically, we don't have any increase of the operator norm. So finally, we get this estimate. This is the estimate that we have in the contact ansatz case. Okay. But the problem with respect with this L2 norm is that, okay, flow is expanding in horizontal direction, but the expanding rate depends on the point. And sometimes there is some small fractal-like set in the phase space in which the flow, semi-flow is strongly expanding than other place. Okay. So suppose that there is some ergodic measure whose depth of exponent is very big and bigger than twice of entropy. Then maybe that should be concentrated on these, on some small subset with small Hausdorff dimension. Okay. So, and if we consider L2 norm, okay, we can capture the cancellation between the function, but we do not know what, in which place the result of superposition can concentrate. So after this, it becomes a problem because some, if the, this, the result of this superposition, if the image is concentrated on this bad region, then it should be expanded strongly later. And this is a situation we like to avoid. Okay. Now what we can do? So this is basically the essence of the problem. Okay. So we consider the superposition of plane waves. And if the image is concentrated on very small but bad fractal-like set, then it causes problems. And I don't know how to, I don't really know how to avoid this situation. Okay. And one idea of mine is that we consider LP norm, because L2 norm captures the cancellation between functions very well, but actually we do not know much about the result. Infinite norm is rather, gives only trivial result. So we go, like to go in between. And if you consider that kind of LP norm, we can get the following result. So this is the main result of my talk. So before we consider L2 norm, but now we consider LP norm, and P depend on the rate. Okay, we can choose P, any P. Okay, and the result is following. So for each P, actually there is some Banner space which is contained in L2P, such that, so LT, this transfer operator for sufficiently large T is bounded on this Banner space, and spectral radius is what we expect. And the main statement is the following. So for any epsilon, actually there exists an open dense subset of ceiling function or roof function. So in general case, then essential spectral radius of LT on this one half space is bounded in this way. And this rho 2PF is defined in this way. Okay, let me examine what this means. So, for example, so this is a formula, okay? And if P equal 1, we can choose P. So if we take P equal 1, so actually this is L2 case, because we call it L2P. So this is L2 case. And then, okay, P is 1, and this is bigger than 1. So actually we always have this, and this part is canceled. So we have this formula. But basically we can choose any P, and maybe one of the good choice is this choice. So we consider the ratio. So this is bigger than or equal to 1 by real inequality. And depending on this number, we choose P. Then, okay, this number p is slightly bigger than this one. So actually, we, max is just p. And we get this formula, right? And what I want to emphasize is that now this number is smaller than topological entropy. So our formula is not vacuous. Okay. And as a consequence, so this is an estimate on the essential spectral radius. But now we can derive the consequence for the periodic orbit counting for this simplified case. And in this case, so we have this asymptotic formula, and this rho bar is just a average of h and rho p. Oh, sorry, I have to write rho 2p here. Okay, and we can take minimum. So basically, this number is smaller than this one. So if this is smaller than or close to one, maybe this is close to the Fubas, that in Fubas formula. But if the this rate, so this basically this is a non-uniformity of the expansion. And if this becomes bigger than our estimate become worse. But anyway, we have some exponentially small error term and some resonance term. Okay. Finally, I would like to speak about the idea of the proof. But idea is not difficult because as I said, in estimating L2 norm, we consider the transversality, and the transversality gives the orthogonality in L2. And we, if you consider L2P norm, maybe we consider this kind of U1, U2, UP, and V1, V2, VP. This kind of integral, and we see how often they disappear. And okay, so this is rather, of course, there are some technicality, but idea itself is not difficult. Just replace L2 norm by L2p. Okay, I stop here. Thank you.